I fucked it up, man. Amp, it is the Arena Ready amp in GarageBand or Logic Pro or whatever the fuck you use. This is the default amp, it's not even, I haven't changed anything about it. So open this guitar, because I can do this. But I've got it set up in such a way this is quite a custom guitar and I can go. Bigsby on myself, put the rolling bridge on myself, put this fancy electronic tuner on myself, and the electronic redo, which put a global volume knob up here. These two are, that is bridge volume, that's neck volume, and this is just a global tone here, and then the pickup selectors here. I use the interface I use, actually watch me fucking, I have a setup video on my channel, go watch that. Anyway. This is just, yeah, this is just global volume. This actually has a different, you notice it's a different knob to these ones. These are the default ones that came with this guitar, but this is one of the ones, one of Brian May's ones. They sell these on the Brian May website. They're actually replica ones, the ones you get default with the Brian May guitar, which is that red one there. And they're smaller. So I bought replica ones, which are a bit wider, and I painted this one black to match this one, because I much prefer these knobs over these plastic, because these plastic ones are kind of slippy and small, while these ones, metal, quite wide, nice grippy thing. Nice. I have to. I can't turn that up all the way to have it. into music. I just did. So this is... this is the pick of destiny. A replica one. Not, find an actual pick around. There's an actual pick. And there is the pick of destiny. So it's a lot bigger and a lot wider. And weirdly, I tried playing it with kind of as... look at that. Oh, shit. I tried playing it with it kind of as a joke. Because it's more of a replica. It's not really meant for playing. You can get replica ones that are like this size and this thinness. That are just this kind of vague shape with the, you know, texture on. This is actually a replica. It's textured, it's painted and everything. It's actually got grooves in it and everything. All these black things are grooves. But weirdly, I'm actually quite like playing with it because due to its thickness, right? You can do that. You can do that a lot easier with this because it's a kind of... it's kind of blunt edge, while this has like a sharp edge, so... it's just a little bit, tiny bit harder with that. I don't know, that's quite nice. Well, because this one, because I leave my hand as I play it, because my hands start like sweating and shit. Throughout when I play... slipping to being like that, and I keep having to adjust it back up like that. But this one, since it's so big and since it has this big flat top bit, you can just sort of hold it like that and put your finger across it like that, and it some adjustment, it never actually moves from there, which is really nice. It's really stable. I don't think it's really meant for this. It's already kind of chipped at the end because it's, I think it's made of plastic. I think so. It's quite nice. I mean, this was like 20 quid. So I kind of feel bad for playing in it because it's more of a replica and I'm worried I'm going to wreck it by playing with it. But I played a fair bit with it and I've been playing reasonably heavily with it. It's all... come on, focus. God, I feel like fucking Dan. Come on. There we go. You see, look, the end is pretty intact still. No paint's chipped off. So... I'm just really liking this. I mean, they're quite expensive. Brian May uses a... oh shit, that's the banjo. Brian May uses sixpences. I've got one blue tack there, so that's what I use on the Brian May guitar sometimes. It's actually a proper replica, it's got Brian May gold strings on and everything, so. But that's what he uses sixpences, because he made the guitar himself, you see, with his father. It's actually, the original's made out of an old fireplace, and like the bridge, the tremolo, or the vibrato arm. It's kind of based off a big, but it's made out of like a, not on that one, that one's like a pass-through one, it's not quite a replica of that one, but, because the replica's like $5,000 and that was like 300, but that, it's made from an old motorcycle, gears and shit, so it's all really hodgepodge. And he used sixpence because he's poor and they were cheaper than picks. It was a little cheaper than picks, actually. And you can do, like, since they're ridged on the edge, you can sort of go, sort of like that. It's got a bit more of a metal-y sound to it because obviously it's ridged. This isn't ridged, but I can kind of do it with this because it's thick. Look, Brian May. Brian May is one of my favourite guitarists. He follows me on Twitter, actually. It was weird. I remember having a conversation about him about fucking Freddie Mercury, and he was like, I was. This was years ago when he first followed me. It was before I was employed and stuff like that. I was kind of down. And he messaged me, and he was like, oh, no, it's all right. You know, I felt down when Freddie died. I was like, all right, yeah. It was really bizarre, because, you know, it's not like Freddie Mercury's just the guy down the street. Is he Freddie fucking Mercury? It's weird having, like, Freddie Mercury's fucking bandmate, the writer of some of the most famous songs of all time, be like, no, I'll be all right. I was like, yeah. Do guitar players get into customizing? Well, it depends. It really depends, because some guitars, people just like them the way they are. I customize this quite a lot. By default, it had the standard Gibson bridge on, the standard Gibson tailpiece, and the standard Gibson tuners, and the standard kind of accompaniment of this, obviously this used to be here. So I've modified this pretty heavily, you know, I've got to put a Bigsby on it. Bigsby doesn't quite fit. I put locking, these are locking as well, so I can really come off. So I've modified this quite a bit. It was about $1,000 when it was new, this guitar, and I probably put maybe like, probably another $1,000 worth of modifications on it. So the guitar sort of doubled in value from the shit I put on it, but... I quite like this guitar, because only 1,000 of the Gothic Morte versions were made with these, like, matte black... Their studio, it's a Les Paul studio, and it's an all-black Les Paul studio with an African Apache... I can't know how to pronounce it. It's like an African blackwood, but it's not ebony. All matte black. All of it. These tuners are active, so they're actually... It's a battery... D battery goes in there, and these are active, so they're more metal. They're more metal guitars. They made an SG version of this as well, but I got the Les Paul. And of course, I made it pretty heavily. It's very unique, I think, this guitar, because it's only 1,000 made, and I think probably I'm the only one who's done this to it. So it's my guitar, you know? Mine. Anyway. I don't know, actually. I think I put when I was tracking my weight a while back, and I am. If you look at the Nerdcubed weight loss track, my weight's on there. Oh shit! My mic's been like up here the whole time. That's why I've been sounding quiet. Whoopsies. I've been playing Steve Ray Vaughan a bit lately, but not like I don't really like learning songs. I like learning the style of. I'm sorry if I'm a bit loud. Now, hang on. Turn myself down a little bit. I'm worried I'm a bit loud. There we go. Yeah, I quite like playing the style of Steve Ray Vaughan. Half bends, he goes. I quite enjoy that. You know, I did learn the Power Rangers theme, but I can't remember it because I never watched Power Rangers, unfortunately. Funny enough, I don't know Cannibal Corpse or anything now. I'm a blues man, damn it, because I'm a blues man. No, okay, fine. whole thing of that. I sort of learn them by ear is the problem with them. That's fine. Learning in my ears is alright. One of my favourite songs to play, right, is that just, it's a song that isn't that hard to play, but it sounds like a lot more impressive than it is. I've lost my, there it is, fuck. See, these fucking picks are black, right, on the back. They're Gibson picks, right? They're black on the back, so I put them down on a black table. They're just lost, like, oh my god, it's gone. I don't know the full song. It's like the slash bit, and there's Lenny Kravitz. That's always on the run. That's a fun warm up song, guys. So that's hard to do. Like that was hard for me to get, because so a lot of the time I learn by technique. I don't actually do lessons or anything. But that's hard to do because it's then. It's sort of to keep hearing low-y, so it's fine. It takes a while, it's stuff like that, you know, I learned that full solo and forgot it all, but a lot of guitar is syncing up this hand, with this hand. You know, like this. This is like that is Sutton Swing. And the problem with Sutton Swing is that is you have to go. When you pull off this one, you have to actually strum it with your little finger, like that. See? That's quite hard to do until you get the time right, until you strum. And you have to actually use your fingers because you can't do it. It's quite hard to do. Actually, I'll turn my voice up then, I'll turn my mic back up. I turned it down because I thought it was too loud, but there you go. I don't know what to do, but quite in trouble when you finally get it, and that's what a lot of this technique is. Like this is from an REO Speedwagon song, I can't remember. That's aggressive with the queen. Actually, what was it? That's the name of Blackery song. I don't really play stuff like that because it's just chords and not really a chord, you know what I mean? I'm sort of a. Like, BB King had a rule, like a no chords rule for a lot of the time. He's sort of always come off the 19th. Be like, I don't playing the style of BB King. I wish I did. I should practice him more. But I don't. I'm more Stevie Ray Vaughan, sort of like Rory Gallagher. Well, I want to point out, I've been playing guitar for like... How many years has it been? 10? No, it's not been 10 years, God. Must be about 12 years now. And this has just come from practice. And the key thing, I think, I've learned guitar, like a lot of old guitarists, quite on purpose, where I've never done lessons or anything. I learn via technique, I learn by ear. So it trains my ear and it trains what I'm doing. Like, I know scales exist, but I don't know any of them. I probably do know them, but I don't know them by name. I don't know theory. I can't read sheet music, but I can. It's just I learn technique and I learn from listening. Might not be the best way, it's probably not the fastest way, but it works for me, and it's how I like learning it. Problem with this pick is it's so big, like with this pick, right? If I'm playing something like that and need to switch the fingers, I just sort of like put it like there between my fingers and just sort of play. Oh, it was off the fret. But you can't really do it with this pick because it's just so goddamn big. Like, where do you put it? Where do you put... Like, what? Sort of turn it round, or because you have to hold it there and sort of, like, go... Sort of flip it round and then... Sort of stick it there. Oh, wait, that's not right. Fuck, I need to... It's so awkward. I like it. I do just play until it sounds right. I mean, I've sort of learned what sounds right over time, and I've learned what I'm doing. You know, I've learned. And that's it. I do just play, like, until it sounds right. I mean, when I originally played, it was a lot of just, like... Sort of like messy stuff, but I've learned what makes stuff sound right. I have a piano. I cannot play the piano well now. I used to have a thing that meant it was always on, but like it also turns off after 15 minutes. And I turned it off, but now the way I turned it off doesn't work anymore, which means like through the MIDI thing and Logic keeps disconnecting, it keeps fucking up the sound settings, so I have to have a mess with it. But I can play chords, but I mean I can't really play as well as I'd like to, you know. I can't play it naturally. I want to learn. For piano, I think I want to get a teacher for that. I think guitar, to me, I like soulful guitarist, you know. To me, guitar's more like about feeling, but piano, I think there's a very technical aspect, you know, to learn how to actually move your hands sort of differently, get them in different rhythms, and not to mention I need to learn how to read sheet music. And I don't know, I think the structure would be nice. I mean, most pianists I like who do like soul and jazz and rock organ, they all learn classical piano first and move from that. So, you know, is the thing. Anyway. Also, I'm doing this on Twitch because they have a music category, and this seems like the place to do this sort of shit.
words for. I don't know the solo for it.
Turn on the guitar and turn up the voice. All right. I don't know if that's alright. Like, I have different audio sliders for the pass through to this and my actual headphones, so I have a different volume to you. But my little finger, that's a lot of practice. Like, doing that is quite, like, it's quite a stretch as well. My hands aren't that big. Like, that is just quite hard to do. It actually still hurts my hand after a while. But yeah, I don't know, I think it did get stronger. That was one of the few things that actually helped me with guitar, was Guitar Hero. Because funnily enough, Guitar Hero, well, it doesn't help you play guitar, it helps you get rhythm. That was what happened. Nerdcubed pillow. You know what? I totally make Nerdcubed body pillows. I totally would if I could find a supplier for them. Like, I'm totally down with stuff like that. Completely and fully. It's really fucking warm in here. I'd have my aircon on, but fucking, I don't want it to ruin the fucking audio. A Dadcubed body pillow. Like, if I made a Dadcubed body pillow, it would just be a beanbag, wouldn't it? That's really mean. I'm right, if you want to learn guitar, like, you can get a guitar kit for like £100. Alright, with a guitar, an extra set of strings, a strap, an amp, and a cable, and a pull of picks. They're cheap, they're not good guitars, but I mean, they're capable guitars. They're not good. I mean, if you buy one of them, you'd be wanting to upgrading. I learned on one of my dad's guitars, and I bought this. I mean, if you're serious about it, I mean, feel free to buy a more expensive guitar, because it will last you. A guitar like this will last ages, and it'll, you know, be worth, you know, a fair amount. But, you know, if you buy, like, a cheap thing, it's not going to be worth anything. You'll just probably throw it out or something. But, you know, if you're serious about it. People always say Rocksmith. I really don't like the idea of Rocksmith. The problem with Rocksmith is they don't actually teach you anything. It's a guitar. I can't play, like, if you give me a Guitar Hero controller, I can't play any Guitar Hero songs like Guitar Hero controller unless I'm in Guitar Hero. Is Rocksmith the same? Just because it teaches you. It might take you to teach you some techniques and sort of get you used to it. But I feel you should just sort of learn yourself. I don't know. I don't know how to describe it. Anyway. Realizing, like, I usually do that, like, if I can't put it in my hand, if I'm just gonna play completely with my fingers, I'll put it in my mouth. But I really can't do that because I'm trying to fucking talk. Oh fuck, I can't even remember. Ah shit. Rocksmith is a cool song to try, but that's the problem. It doesn't, you don't really learn from it, is the problem. Like, to learn, you need to get into your head. You know, Rocksmith doesn't really teach you much. I mean, one of the ways I got into it was I'd listen to a song I liked, and I would just play along with it and try and get to the tone. You know, that's what I did. If you were on my stream the other day, it's Steve Ray Vaughan's song at the start, and I played along with it. You know, I didn't actually play what he was playing, but I played along with the style he was doing. So, you know. Guitar is very frustrating when you can't play. Any instrument is very frustrating when you can't play. Actually, hang on. I have got a lot of instruments. Oh, shit. Let's turn this on. There we go. Tune, but you know, like stuff is difficult to learn when you first try it. I've got a banjo, a bass, ukulele, some weird Moroccan instrument, got a saxophone and a trumpet and a violin. I mean the saxophone and the trumpet have sort of taken a back seat, because much like guitar, it is frustrating when you can't play them, not to mention the saxophone and the trumpet. The saxophone and the trumpet, they're very loud. If I turn this down, no one's going to hear that, but, saxophone and the trumpet, since it's such, like, mouth control, when you can't play them, they're just really loud and they sound like a dying cat, so, yeah, it's kind of put off, really. Yeah, no, this is the Porsche down, where is it, there it is. Dan bought me this Porsche for getting him free Lego. So this might not be Dan's Porsche, but Dan bought me the Porsche. I've actually got a, above that, I've got like an X-wing up here, as well. Also, just above the Porsche, an Azkaban mask. I've got a replica. NXT belt as well. And there's a helicarrier there as well. There. Good old haircut. When he sort of half my leg was up here, like there's a load of Batman Lego on the table over there. I've got that on Twitter. But the thing is, I used to play the euphonium when I was I was in school. I used to play the euphonium, which is it's a smaller tuba, basically. It's just a smaller tuba, and I could play that. And in theory, you know, the trumpet is it's the same. It's just small. It uses the same valves. It has the same mouth control. You know, it'd be some different technique, but I figured, you know, I know how to play it. But then I realized when I got the trumpet that I haven't actually played the euphonium in like 15 years. So yeah. Yeah, I know a lot of people really don't like the Azkaban mask. I quite like it though. I put it on a polystyrene head. Ooh, I am Asuka. I keep on saying Asuka. I'm here to haunt you. Look into my eyes. I do like that. I don't know why people find that freaky. I found that mask quite nice. Also, actually. Ghost Rider. This camera was more zoomed out initially, but I realised it was a problem because I'm standing back here, and the guitar was like a lot more zoomed out. So. I do not have any pets. No. I do have Lego. Yeah. Pets are too much effort, really. I do like a lot of animals, but the problem with it, I don't have any plants either because I forget about them, which sounds really mean, but I do. I forget about pets. I forget about plants. My plants die on me, and I'd rather not have a pet because it's just something I kind of remember. I go, oh shit, and it's not fair to the pet, really. I mean, I wouldn't mind some like a low sort of maintenance pet, you know. I've always wanted a tortoise because they don't really give a shit. They just sort of hide. They just sort of sit there, really. They hibernate for half the damn year. They just sort of sit around. It's like, hey, maybe it's a tortoise. And they don't really hurt you. They're too slow to really do anything. They're friendly, you know. Give them a piece of fruit and they go nom 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 on the piece of fruit and you pick them up by the shell and like, I can't do anything, why are you doing this? House cats, yeah, well, house cats, yeah, but the problem is I'm in a flat, I'm not even allowed pets here, even to watch them, so. Well, turtles bite really painfully, yeah, I'm sure they do, but the thing is they're so slow and, you know, you can kind of just pick them off, but, you know, it's kind of, if you get bitten by a turtle, really, it's your own fault, isn't it? Yeah, cats are great, but obviously I'm in a flat, so. My mother has an African grey parrot. It was actually the family parrot when I sort of lived. They live about 60 years. They're very intelligent. They're sort of up there with the African greys specifically, or up there with dolphins and gorillas. In the intelligence, they're about as intelligent, supposedly, as about a 5-year-old child, human child, and the emotional intelligence of like a 2-3-year-old child. They can do maths and shit if you teach them. They understand language to a basic level. Yeah, they're interesting. They're annoying though, the parrots, because they have sharp talons, not too sharp, but they're sharp, and they can fly, and they have a very strong beak for biting nuts. So, unlike the macaws, the really brightly coloured ones, which are bigger, they have bigger things, but they're stupider, so you can train them easily. The African greys, they fucking know. They fucking know, you know, they fucking know when you're trying to train them. They'll be a bitch to you. You know, and they bite, and they're kind of terrifying, because, you know, they can just come up to you, land on you, bite you, and fly away, and you can't really do anything about that. You know, they're hard to manage. But, you know, my mother sort of bonded with them. Because they can generally bond with a person, and you know, gives them a lot of attention. That's nice. Yeah, tortoises can't fly. I like cats though. I had cats when I was younger. And cats are very nice pets to have. We'll be right back. You can clip the wings, but it's cruel. It's very cruel to clip the wings. Like, it's considered generally very cruel to clip a parrot's wings because, you know, they're sort of meant to fly. You know, you can't just... You can calf clip them, apparently, is a thing you can do where they can fly a bit, but, you know, because we lost him once when I was hungry. He got out the kitchen door and he just flew off. We got him back. Apparently he flew off, and he, about a day later, we got a call from a guy who found him, and apparently he flew over to this park, and he was sort of wandering around the park going, "Ooh, look," he was about a year old. He flew over, he looked at the park, and then magpies attacked him, like three magpies attacked him, and he was fucking terrified, and this fucking guy and his dog walked past, and he just fucking flew to this, he flew onto this guy's shoulder and just sat there to get away from these fucking magpies. Like, I took him back to his house, and we got him back. It's hilarious. I'm connected directly to your computer. This is, shit. It's a, thingy. There we go, yeah. The Arena Ready one, but I really like the Arena Ready one because it's got a nice amount of reverb. It's like a standard sort of Morphly amp. But you can sort of, if you turn the volume down and stuff and turn it to the neck, you can understand a bit. Then you can just sort of, like, the way this guitar's set up is that since I've got the two independent volume controls as well as the master, I can just go, like, switch, and it's like that, and then I can switch back, and it's really nice. That's why I set this guitar up like that, so I can go from just this really nice clean to just a flick of a flick of the switch on the guitar. I don't even have an effects pedal or anything. It's really nice. I quite like the look of corn snakes. That the snakes, but they don't have any fangs or anything. They're constrictors, so they have teeth, but like really small teeth. Like, their bite is probably just harmless. It just makes you bleed a tiny bit. It's probably not very painful bite at all, and they're not usual to bite. Apparently, they're very docile and friendly. Just feed them like a mouse once a month or something. The podcast is meant to be yesterday, and I said it was cancelled this week. It wasn't postponed until Thursday, it was just cancelled. I don't know what the snake Dan and Rebecca have, actually. This is a master volume. I like it here. I just... Because, you see, the Bigsby makes it a bit more difficult to access this area, unless it's sort of down here, but, you know, if you want to play it, if you want to sort of go around... So I'll keep it up, so this is a bit more difficult. This is stuff you'd like to do when you have a break, but this just means I can adjust the volume on the fly quickly. Yeah, sounds great. I mean, actually, it's weird. I don't know many songs that are played with a Les Paul with a Bigsby, and Barracuda is one of them. She plays it, not in a studio, obviously, but she plays it on a custom. Because the Bigsby's kind of a more subtle tremolo. Sorry, a sort of vibrato. What's my favourite metal band? Metal band. I don't like metal. shit. Let me think. Some favorite band in general, probably Queen. Change the strings in this is a fucking huge pain in the ass, because these are these Tronicle tuners, they're locking and they're really awkward, and then trying to deal with the Bigsby at the same time, because you have to pull them, but then you're trying to lock them, it's a real fucking pain to string this goddamn guitar. But ever since I restrung, because I only restring it once a year, because these strings are fucking great, they don't need restringing very often. Ever since this has been a bit close to the roll it down here a bit. Anyway. Beatles fan, see, I'm using my fancy electronic tuners. I do like them. It's like the future is here. Sometimes they're a bit inaccurate. Especially the G string, very inaccurate with the G string, there we go. Can I play Jimi Hendrix? I can play one Jimi Hendrix song. Oh god. Manic Depression. That's how I learn songs, by the way, just sort of like one more time. I'm not really that into Hendrix, the problem. I said I'm not Queen and and Lizzie and the like. I learned sort of half bits of songs and don't know, or not sort of fully. Thank you. Sultan's a swing. Good old Sultan's a swing. I do like this. This is one of the songs. I spent a year learning the solo for Sultan's a swing. Now I don't know all the fills. I mean, you know the. After every change, it's usually a fill. It's the first one. There's a bunch of fills, and it's like, you know, there's the, when the time bell rings. I don't know any of them. I spent all the time learning the fucking solo, and it's mainly just. Maybe that bit, and, you know, the rest is kind of quite hard, you know, you're doing harmonics here. So it's, so harmonic. Playing it full speed, but you know, it's quite, it's taught me a lot of techniques, this. And this isn't, I learned this from a tab, but you know, this bit, like, you want stuff to you, want like this bit, like that isn't in the tab, just, but you know, it sounds nice. And it's nice, it's a nice sort of like. It's a really nice soft song. It's one of the very few songs I know where the solo is actually playing with, you know, finger picking. I don't write my own stuff, I can't write songs, unfortunately. I know, I know I am. The dragon and the old master and the potion to let's get it more down in the basement. Not this set of invading. What's all of this? Shit. Oh.
Hear that bit. I'm practicing this bit loads. Because doing stuff like that loud fast is... I don't know that, but I've learned a lot of songs over the years and I've forgotten most of them. It's I think one of the issues with playing this on. I don't learn many full songs as well either. I learn a lot of riffs but not like the full song is the problem. Somebody to love, I just don't stop me now again, No, I can play it. I can play it as well. I can play it. I remember being able to play that was quite fast. I'm going to press status quo. Sabbath. know the solo. I kind of learned that much of the solo and gave up. I can play the boots. I think I learned the solo from that, but I can't remember it for the fucking life of me. I don't know. If you list any punk bands, I'm not going to be able to play them. If there's me some blues artists, I'll probably be able to play them. But the problem is, I can't, most of the songs I've played are the ones I remember. I don't remember the other ones because I just don't play them enough. Zeppelin, I learned some Zeppelin, I can't remember it. Clapton, oh god, I know Clapton, I know some Clapton, I can't remember it. This is the problem. What's a fucking Clapton song? I don't remember these things, just because they're not in the forefront of my mind, I forget them, you know. Oh, Layla. Layla was written about George Harrison's wife. Because George Harrison's wife, right, they were married, and Eric Clapton and George Harrison, good friends, you know, because obviously, while my guitar didn't reap the solo on that, was done by Mr. Eric Clapton himself. And George and Eric were good friends, and, well, Eric Clapton fell in love with George Harrison's wife, and they wrote about Layla, and Layla was George Harrison's wife. That wasn't her name, but, you know, he used Layla as the name for that. And eventually, George Harrison and her split, and Eric Clapton married her, and George Harrison and Eric Clapton still stayed friends. You know, George Harrison was a dude. There's an interesting fact. I know a lot about George Harrison specifically and the Beatles a bit. I know quite a lot about the Beatles, but specifically George Harrison, and I know a lot about Queen. I'll joke on the thief. Oh, fuck. I can't remember it for life, mate. I can't remember it. I know Chuck Berry, you know. Oh, to play that before, though. Yeah, that's interesting, isn't it? You see, the more you know, the more you know. The funny thing is, I did do a full cover of Joke and the Thief, like a full one. Like, I did everything. I did the bass, the guitar, I did the drums with my mouth, and I did the singing. It's on SoundCloud, but I can't even remember it. I did play the stuff I know well. I don't really remember anything else that was the annoying thing. The problem is, for the past like couple of years, I haven't learned really anything new. I've been mainly just doing technique. So, like, you know, me playing isn't from a song, it's just me learning a technique, and I haven't really been practicing. I haven't really been learning the songs I knew. That's all right. That's not it. It's there we go, right. I learned that. That was one of the first songs I learned. But Yoda was a black sheep who refused. I don't know the full words, but Yoda was a black sheep. I taste the jam. You could see his fucking rocking all the time. You don't want to taste the jam, but all the planets didn't lie. All the dragon will face a disaster. All the dragon will face a disaster in his cage. And I lost his fucking marbles, the wrong and shattered the hood. So try to fuck the dragon, fuck the lines, and fuck the hood. And if you try to fuck me, I shall fuck you too. Gonna get it on when the party's on. So set the show when the party's on. You disobey in my hands, so my way on the board. Nobody's turned out better than you, as long as you know. You don't know what your faith has come from, but that's hell. You're walking over together to where he wants to be the hell. You become a man, so it's really so far out of the tree. You're hollering with an action, okay, I see you. Okay, I see you, okay. Dio, can you hear me? Which I learned, but I don't remember. Dio, can you hear me? I am lost and so alone. I'm asking for your guidance when you come down from your throne. I need a right compadre who will teach me how to rock. Your father thinks you're evil, bad man, he can suck a cock. Rock is not the devil's work, it's magical and ran. I'll never rock as long as I'm stuck here with my... I'm stuck here with my... Tables, you are hungry for the rock, but to learn the ancient method, secret door, you must come with me. Mm-hmm. where the ocean makes the sound. Fall is gone right, and the world must all seem kind. I have a fortune, and I know I must run. Till the ocean will make me tears, and I don't want to turn. I know the lyrics to pretty much every Tenacious D song, but you know. It's a low hanging fruit. Think of Destiny was released, it was about how the critics said that the D was done and sun had set and the chapter had flown. But one thing no one thought about was the D would rise again, just like the Phoenix. Would rise? I don't know I don't know most of the ones from Rise of the Phoenix, but I do more ones. Oh, fuck. I knew Beezer Boss. How did Beezer Boss go? I can't remember for the fucking life of me. I challenge you to a rock off. Give us one chance to rock your socks off. Fuck the. Take Cage back to hell. Like, what? To be a little. It's fine! Ah, fuck. I knew the whole thing. I knew the fuck. I can't remember any of it. I'm the devil, I can do what I want. Whatever I want, I'm gonna do. Never been a rock after that I've ever lost. I can't wait to take Cage back to hell. I'm gonna fill him in my activist gel. I make him squeal like the Scarlet Pimpernel. No, there's just no way that we can win. That was a masterpiece. He rocked too hard because he's not a mortal man. God damn it, Cage. He's gonna make it his sixth slave. You're gonna gargle mayonnaise unless he puts a massive monster mamma jammo. No. We've been through so much shit, deactivated lasers with my dick, and now it's time to blow this fucker down. Okay, now it's time to blow doors down. Tables, now it's time to blow doors down. Shit. Okay, now it's time to blow doors down. Hey, tables, now it's time to blow doors down. Come on, turn it now it's time to show down. Then you are the right one, tell you to turn it down. I really feel that now it's time to blow this fucking town. He's gonna rape me if we do not blow this down. Okay, now it's our show. Come on, I don't know that bit. You are the devil, we are the D. We are the D, 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 we are the D. That was that fucking song. Come on, Angel, come on. No, there's my lightning stick. Yeah, you know, you get it. You get the picture. Is it too loud? Is it peaking? Because if it's peaking, the problem is I'm using my. I'm using this mic because this mic over here is not really long enough to reach my, you see, it's not really big enough to reach my mouth. I'd have to sort of stand over here. I can't angle the camera that way, so, you know, fuck it. What's the other one? Low hanging fruit is a freak. Gonna hang out now and then the damn fucking baby. Low hanging fruit. Gonna be my home, hot red potatoes and the love that's strong. The tenacious D had died. What will we do? We'll have to laser off the D tattoo. Fuck. It's really annoying me now because I've learnt loads of the songs. I can't fucking remember a single goddamn thing. Ah, it's gonna piss me the fuck off. Whatever. Anyway. A fucking really fast Deep Purple song as well. That's kind of, they're gonna jam in. This is the problem. Now, if you ever watched Phil X, he used to do sort of guitar demos for with really fancy guitars, vintage guitars and stuff like that. And he had the problem where he'd sit there and he's like, oh, I'll play this song. He's like, oh, I can't remember. And it's completely, you learn so many songs, you forget them. I've not played Avenged Sevenfold. Like, I don't know metal. I don't play metal or like punk or anything like that. Yeah, I played Johnny B. Good. So I play metal, like just because it looks like a metal guitar doesn't mean it has to be a metal guitar. Oh, well, AC/DC's fucking. I know it's going to be that.
Yes, I know.
It was. Let's get it. I don't know. Layla. I played it, yeah. I want to Ogre Battle by Queen. That's from the first album. Fine. Favorite solo to bass. Someone's a swing. Hang on. Let's put it down to like flat. Play, I can play back, Betty. You should be able to play back, Betty, as well. That's really annoying. Thank you. to laugh. Fucking. Bum, bum, bum. If you use different tuning for it, it's quite nice, and also just handy. I mean, it's expensive, but fuck it. I mean, it's cool. You know, frankly, I mean, I'm just more amused by the fact I can just... I hate having to tune my guitar. That's one of the most annoying things. Well, it's not out of tune, it was an E-flat. That's why it sounded out of tune. It's an E-flat. Also, as well, with the Bigsby, it goes out of tune a lot, especially since I bend so much. I could just go out of tune pretty easily, that's why, another reason I got it. Also, Crazy... Well, the original Crazy Frog's terrible. It good. Well, no, the original Axel F is good, but... finish it now, so I'll finish in 10 minutes. So if anyone has any requests for songs I've already done, I'll do them again, but aside from that, I can't really sort of learn new stuff on the fly like this. The guitar did just tune itself. It's got an automatic tuner on. It has a battery, and it's a bit annoying because my guitar requires two batteries to function properly. It requires a battery in this, and it requires a battery, there, a D battery in there to power the tuners properly. So it's not exactly an acoustic thing, because it does require two batteries. And I lost the charger for this fucking battery. Thankfully, my father has about four of these goddamn tuners, so he had spares. And these just take... this just take D batteries, but you know, it's still annoying. But anyway, Gibson actually... Gibson bought the company that makes the E-tronical. And last year's all last year's standard models included one of these tuners, these auto tuners, aren't they? Were branded Gibson Mini E-Tunes, because they used to have tuners that are, they had a tuner down here and the wires ran up. So you made the selection down here, but these are just completely confined to the head snook. And they bought Tronicle, but diehard Gibson fans really didn't like the inclusion of the Mini E-Tune. They really didn't, so they're off all the standard models now, which is quite unfortunate, because these are about £200, these units. They're quite expensive, so... You know, when you could buy a new SG, for example, for like, you know, £600, and you got one of these included, it was a pretty good damn deal. If you buy a new SG now, you know, you have to pay an extra £200 if you want one of these. Quite unfortunate, really. It's called Tronicle. They're a German company. Tronicle. Yeah, so they are quite expensive, and you need to make some print-offs, and make sure it's the right size for your guitar. Gibson Les Pauls are really standard for them. It's a really standard size. But if you have a bit of a different guitar, you'll have to make sure to measure it. Anyway. Okay, I know. Oh, shit. The problem with this, right, is I'll try and show you. When you basically, to tune it to a certain tuning, you tap it twice. That's not the right button, is it? There we go, you tap it twice. So, that's not right, I've tapped it once. So, see, that is standard there. I can move it along, and that'd be E flat. But it's got those six, and then about six of these colours. So, it's got quite a lot of tunings. Unfortunately, since it's just this really basic screen, it's very hard to tell what they are unless it comes with a guidebook. But I always forget which is which, so I never know what fucking drop D is. There we go, that's drop D. Maybe you can manually tune it, it's just very slow. Well, unless you've got batteries in it. If you've got batteries in it, it's very slow, as I learned when I was restringing it without any batteries in. Remember the lyrics. She was a rare thing. Fan as a bee's. Ah, fuck, rare thing. Fan as a bee's. No, hang on. See, I'm used to playing up here, but I realised like the other day you're supposed to play it with a caper. What the fuck? I'm playing it wrong the whole time. But since the, markers are in different places comparatively to up here. It's a bit confusing. She was a rare thing, fine as a bee's wing. So fine, a breath of wind blow. Fuck. Nah. Yeah. Remember, Bee's Wing by fucking Richard Thompson. For fuck's sake. Here, but down there, I just get confused. If I could just take all this world. If I could just take all hell this world's hell. If I could back it up. Nah. Fuck. Because I'm a bit tired. I'm gonna go to bed after this. It's annoying, but that's they're very nice songs. They're two of the kind of more advanced songs I know on acoustic, but I'm not gonna switch to the acoustic because I don't have to fucking mess with the microphone and shit. Isn't a bass guitar a guitar without the high E? It's usually four strings, bass guitar. It's usually these four, these bottom four, and a lower octave, yeah, actually. That's fine. That's fine. Well then, I don't fucking get this. Fucking get it. Crap out of the way. Get things pretty easily, it turns out. I used to learn a lot of bass. I knew a couple of Queen songs in the bass. I play slap. I don't really know. Like, the problem is, I don't know how to read cheap music. Fuck. Not working off tabs either, to clarify. Oh, it's a much shiny guitar, that one. Oh, fuck. Oh, God, this guitar's stuck to me now. Hang on. I always wanted one of the ES guitars, you know, the one that, like, fucking thingy plays from Led Zeppelin. God, what's the fucking name now, Jesus. It's basically an SG with a bass, and it's a two-neck guitar. I always wanted one of those, kind of. Anyway, I'm going to finish up now, because my cable's on the floor. And, yeah, this is all from memory. I should really practice more. I'll practice more for next time. I'll do another one of these in future, because I feel these are kind of fun. It's kind of an excuse to play guitar for long periods of time. Thank you for coming. Oh, I can do an actual middle finger. The fucking future is here.